Shalom and welcome to The Lord Reigns right here at OCN, your favorite Christian television station, 24 hours, 7 days a week. That's right, your favorite. And you can view us in many ways. You can view us through the Galaxy 19 satellite if you have the dish, or live stream OCNbroadcasting.com, and you can go straight to Watch Live. And if you have Roku, you can also view us on your television. You can using the Roku device. Many ways around the world. Oh, and we have the largest YouTube channel. Oh, my. It's the talk of the town and the talk of the universe. So tell your friends about OCN, Open Door Communication Network. Again, your favorite Christian television station. And today you are in for something good. Yes, you heard me. Before we get started, I want us to read the word from Matthew chapter 6, verse 33. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. So we are going to zero into the word of God using the scripture today. But before we get started, we have a surprise for you. Yes, an awesome surprise. We have OCN theme song composed by no other but the favorite Christian country musician. She is a writer. She is a song artist known around the world. No other but Wendy Adams. Yes. Oh my God. So sit tight and be blessed as she sings the OCN theme song that the Lord gave to her for OCN. Amen.
OCN is there to help you on God's word. Be true to
Brother David, it wasn't that beautiful.
Oh, that was gorgeous.
Oh,
and tell us about what OCN is for.
Oh,
the
my
ministry,
my.
The heart.
Amen.
You know, well, I had a very good time writing that.
Amen. Yeah. Tell us a little bit about it.
Because of the fact of what it stands for.
Yes.
And what it's doing. And what it's doing all over the world.
Yes.
Because we are working towards that master plan.
Yes, we are.
And we are holding up each other. Regardless
yes.
of where they're at. And this last week and stuff, they've had a lot of things going on
yes.
this last week on the news. And it's really touched my heart. Is we've had earthquakes and we've had floods.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, hey, I just came from Tennessee.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll tell you, they got water. We need water.
And we pray that the rain will come in Jesus' name.
That's
we're
true.
Going to have you say a little bit, talk a little bit more. But let's go to your husband, Pastor David. What is the Lord saying to you? I know you shared a little bit about Matthew chapter 6, verse 33. And before you get started, let me read that scripture again in
yes.
Amplified. I want to read it from the Amplified
Thank you.
Version.
It's so
and
gorgeous.
We're going to hear from Pastor David Adams, that is, by the way, that is Wendy's husband,
yes.
if you don't know. I like you two are just matching with
Ooh.
your colors.
They're beautiful.
Amen. So it says in Amplified, but seek, in other words, aim at and strive after, first of all, his kingdom and his righteousness, his way of doing and being right. And then all these things taken together will be given you besides.
That's so true, isn't
Amen.
It? Yes. I love God's word.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you know, it's amazing how you can read God's word all your life. And many times something doesn't just click in.
Mm-hmm.
I've probably heard this verse 1,000 times growing up in a good Bible teaching, believing church, super pastors we had. But I went to Bible college, and there's just no way that I could afford to go to Bible college. But God called me. I started the summer with $1 in the bank, and God gave me 3 jobs. I went to Bible college.
Wow.
I paid my tuition, went over and I bought my books. I was walking out across the campus, and God said, check your finances. I reached in my pocket, and I started counting
Jesus.
Out the change. I had 99 cents in my pocket. I started the summer with $1. God knew to the penny of what I needed. Somewhere I blew a penny along the way. And yet I went to our first service that night at our chapel. And the person who was president of our missionary society, his name was Nick Anderson, stood up and he read this verse and it hit me like a ton of bricks. I'd never really thought about it before. If I put God first in my life,
my God,
the impossible is not His possibility.
Amen.
It's His miracle.
Amen.
He's the one that does it. If I
Hallelujah.
Seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, if I go according to His call, I don't have to worry about the finances.
He'll
take care of it. As long as I do my part,
you,
the miracles will flow moment by moment, day
yes.
by day
yes.
by day.
Hallelujah.
This became my theme scripture. For those 4 years of Bible college, of living the impossible.
Amen.
Getting up in the morning sometimes and, whoa, I don't have any food to eat. And watch it just appear. I mean, one day coming home, I had $5. I put it in my gas tank so I could get to the church that I'd started. I was trying to get it there. And I had a little package of crackers. And for that week, I'd eat one cracker a day.
My God.
That was the thing there. And I ate my last cracker that morning. But when I'd go to work, for some reason, the boss's wife would bring a beautiful lunch for all of us
wow.
during that time.
But
I go home that night knowing I have no food. I pull up and there's boxes and
wow.
boxes
Hallelujah.
And boxes of groceries and food. And inside,
wow.
there's an envelope with money in it. I
my
mean,
God.
Quite a bit of money.
Ooh.
No, there was a card, but no name, no signature
My
on
God.
It.
My God.
You know, and God said to me, you know, Dave, if you would have believed me a week ago, this would have been at your door then, because that's when you would have needed it.
Wow.
the faith that it takes for these things. I love this because this is in the Sermon on the Mount. Mm-hmm. You go to Matthew chapter 5, and Jesus goes up the mountain, and all the disciples and all of the friends around, the things that they follow him. He doesn't get a break. Mm-hmm. So he sits down and he teaches through Matthew chapter 5, 6, and 7, what we call the Sermon on the Mount. Mm-hmm. And in the middle of it, this is this promise. But he's talking about, if God takes care of the flowers of the field, and I look at the beautiful flowers around here, and you go, every one of them is so beautiful, but it's different.
Mm. Yes,
there's not a duplicate of that one in the whole world, even though there's trillions of them.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen.
He talks about the little sparrow.
Yes.
You know, they're not worth much to us. In Luke, it talks about, you know, if you wanted to buy a sparrow, you can buy two of them for a penny. They're just no value. Mm. To mankind, but if you had two pennies, they just throw in an extra one. You can get five for two pennies. Mm. You know, there's just not much value to us. But the Bible says that God knows every one of them.
Hallelujah.
He gives them a name.
Yes, he does.
He sees every move that they make.
He
takes care of them. They don't build houses.
Hallelujah.
They don't have refrigerators to store things in.
Yes.
They don't even think about it because the God that supplied for them that yesterday is going to supply for them today.
And that's what grace of God is all about.
That's right.
His grace supplies.
That's right.
The grace of God will not demand. Jesus Christ came and paid the price for you and I.
Yes.
When he hung on that cross, he said, it's finished.
Mm-hmm.
He became poor that you and I will be rich. And that's what testimony he's given, that God supplied the need for him when he was in college. Mm-hmm. He did not have to sweat. Grace of God is effortless. See, when you are striving and you are striving, that means you are not resting in the Lord that has promised you.
Amen.
I'm
Amen.
Telling you, Hallelujah. He has promised to meet every need in your life. Hallelujah. We've got to know Ephesians 2, 8, 9, and tells us, it's by grace that we are saved.
Hallelujah.
Unmerited favor.
Yes.
He cleansed us from our sin,
Amen.
Sickness, Amen. Disease, all Hallelujah. Calamities, Hallelujah. All the curses of the law. Poverty is a curse.
Hallelujah.
Sickness is a curse. And he took all that away for you and I.
Yes.
You don't have to do anything anymore but to rest in him. And that's what he's talking about here. I remember coming over to United States of America. I knew no one, no one. I went to the school right there in Jackson, Tennessee. I knew no one, nobody. They met me at the airport with my name. I raised my hand. They knew who I was. And then they took me to the dorm. Knew no one in the whole United States of America. And I'm here to tell you the grace of God supplied every need. And today, I know it's by his grace that I'm an electrical engineer working for the best companies in the world.
Jesus.
And now the Lord is using OCN to send the gospel around the world. It is his grace.
Thank you, Jesus.
His grace is sufficient to meet your need.
Hallelujah.
What the scripture is saying, simply rely on him. Seeking him is not something you do by your effort. It's simply saying, rely on Jesus Christ, who is able to meet your need. Yes, Pastor David, go ahead and share some more. I just got excited.
Oh, it's so neat how our Heavenly Father supplies our needs, the miracles that are there day after day. Mm-hmm. We had a huge one just a few days ago that I'm going to let Wendy share that.
Yeah.
That's such
Before
a special
she shares
one.
That, can you sing?
Okay.
Yeah, can you sing your, I know, oh my man. Then we want to hear, my God, he is not just a pastor. He has the best male voice I have ever heard. It's awesome. Not only that, but anointed. So be blessed.
You know, when you fall in love with somebody, and they become so special to you, you want to share that. You want to say to them how much you feel about them. And you say, you know, I love you.
Mm-hmm.
I adore you.
Mm-hmm.
You're so special to me. You're the greatest. You're my sweetie. You're my all in all, my love. But pretty soon you just kind of run out of words for it. And you just want to express so much more. I think this is kind of what this song is trying to say. about our love for our Lord.
Us that he would be a counselor, a mighty God and a Prince of Peace. He promised us that he would be a father and he would love us with a love that would never, never cease. I tried him. Oh, I found his promises, they're all true. He's everything he said that he would be. The finest words I know could not begin to tell just how much my Jesus really means to me. For he's more wonderful than my mind can conceive. He's much more wonderful than my heart can believe. He goes beyond my highest hopes and even my fondest dreams. He's everything that my soul ever longed for, everything he promised, and so much more, more than amazing, more than marvelous, much more than miraculous could ever be. That's what Jesus is to me. I stand amazed to think the King of Glory would come to live within the heart of man. I marvel just to know he really loves me. When I think of who he is and then who I am, for he's my mind can conceive. He's much more wonderful than my heart can believe. He goes beyond all my highest hopes and even my fondest dreams. He's everything that my soul ever longed for, everything he promised, and so much more, more than amazing, more than marvelous, much more than miraculous could ever be. That's what Jesus is to me. That's what he is to me. He's everything that my soul ever longed for, everything he promised, And so much more, more than amazing, more than marvelous, much more than miraculous. Could ever be more than wonderful, that much more than wonderful. That's what Jesus is to me. More than wonderful to me. My wonderful Lord.
Thank you. Hallelujah. He is indeed wonderful. That was an awesome, beautiful, anointed, wonderful song. Well, before we come back to Pastor David, because you're going to pray for the people that are watching that need to receive Jesus, I want us to go to my beloved friend, Wendy. Oh, my. You know, I told her, probably think the first time or second time around I met her right here at the studio, and I said, I just love the way you minister to the Lord in song. Can you just trust the Holy Spirit to give you the theme song for OCN? She looked at me and said, she said, okay, just like that. Sure. And before I knew it, we had our theme song. She is a humble woman of God, songwriter, and I tell you, as far as I'm concerned, the most anointed country musician I've ever heard from, the most anointed. So I want everyone to welcome Wendy. Amen.
Yeah. Yes. Well, thank you. You know, Bishop, God is good.
Amen.
And His mercy endures forever.
Amen.
And I have so much to be thankful for. I've just come back from doing some recordings in Memphis, Tennessee, as well as some movies. And I have been asked to write theme songs for their movies, and I'm excited about that because I'm in it, and it's a gospel movie, and it's called According to Jim Bob, and it is hilarious. You're going to love the movie. I have something to share also. This last week, as my husband David was sharing, we got a phone call from our daughter, Patricia. And she's in Milwaukee, she's in Wisconsin, and she's there, and she went to the doctor, and they did a test on her. First of all, they told her that she needed to come in and get a biopsy, because she had, they thought that she was she had cancer. And so she went in and she got the biopsy, and then she came back and called us on the phone, and she crying, and she says, Mama and Daddy, she says, they said I have stage 3 cancer.
Jesus.
And I said to him, I said to her, Patricia, I said, do you believe God? I said, I believe what God's right now touching you. And so her daddy got on the phone too with her and me, and we prayed for her. And we told her to touch right here, or the thyroid, and we prayed. Well, they called her the next 3 days and scheduled surgery to go in to remove it. And I couldn't be there. I wanted to, but financially we were just couldn't make it. But anyway, it was something that God did, because He's the healer. He does it
Amen.
All.
Amen.
And so they did the surgery, and right away they took out the thyroid, and they took it in and had it checked. And it came back, no cancer.
No cancer.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
The cancer was gone.
What a healer.
Hallelujah.
And I told her, I said, Patricia, that's God. You know, ever since she's a little girl, we've believed in God, and I have preached to her about God. And even as she became a mother and her children, I did the same thing with them. There is nothing impossible with God.
Amen. Nothing.
He loves to hear.
God says in His Word that He, you ask and He will give to you.
Amen. Yes.
And so what we did, David, is we asked.
Amen.
That's right.
And where did God? And yes, in the name of Jesus, and the cancer is gone.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Also, we have so far received money for making a trip. They're going to be going there in July. We're going to go there on the 11th of July and be there for 5 days to be with her. And it was made possible through prayer.
Mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
It was made possible.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. That's what Pastor David just preached on.
Yes.
That's
right. Yes. He supplies our needs.
And the grace of God has supplied the needs.
Yes, He does.
Yes.
He said that He will supply our needs according to His riches and glory.
Amen. Through Christ Jesus.
And He has supplied me with so much, Bishop. He has. I mean, I have got a wonderful, my own designer.
Amen. Amen. And we're going to get to her.
Amen.
Yeah. But, go ahead.
But I am just so thankful, though, what God can do. And He said in His Word that He wants to do exceeding abundantly above all we could ask or think.
Amen. Yes.
And that's in our wedding rings.
Yes. Right here.
Wow.
We have it in our wedding rings that He wants to do that.
Wow.
And what He's done for me, what He's done for you, what He's done for Patricia.
Amen.
I mean, He wants to do for you.
Yes.
Amen.
He says all you have to do is ask.
Mm.
And I believe that there's people right now watching.
Yes.
Ooh.
And I believe that right now they are actually, they're suffering.
Mm.
They're suffering with all kinds of diseases. Yes. Well, I know a healer.
Mm,
and awesome. I know that healer is. He is my Heavenly Father. And He will be yours too.
Amen.
Because if you ask, it says, if you ask, He will supply your needs.
Amen.
And He will come into your heart.
Yes.
And He will take away all your pain or suffering.
Yes, Lord.
Because that's my God.
So, Wendy, why don't you pray? You just talked about the healing. I believe the Lord is giving you that prophetic word. We need to pray, but I want to read that Mark 11 that you are quoting, verse 24. Therefore, I say unto you, what things soever you desire, when you pray, believe that you receive them and you shall have them. So just stretch forth your hand and pray for those that are believing God for healing in their physical body.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We give you praise, Jesus. Father. We thank you, Father, that you are the healer. Father, that you supply our needs. Lord Jesus, we just ask you right now to touch those people out there and to give them, Lord, to give them the peace that passeth all understanding.
Yes.
Give them what they desire, their heart's desire. We give you praise and we give you glory in Jesus' name. Oh, my goodness. Mark, you have a spot on your lung, and right now, God said that He's healing that. You've been asking for healing now for a long time. But He said that He is taking it out. Elizabeth, you have a growth on your kidney. They want to remove it, Lord. But we know what God's doing right now. You're feeling a heat go through your body. And Elizabeth, you are healed in the name of Jesus. It says it. I see Mark. Mark, you have something on your throat right now. And it is not cancer. Okay. It is it's a polyp, but it ain't cancer.
Thank Amen.
You, Lord.
But
thank you, Lord,
Jesus. God is dissolving it right now.
Yes, thank you, Lord. Yes.
And you are healed
Amen.
By the name
thank
of
you, Lord
Jesus.
Martha, there's a child that you have been praying for.
Jesus.
And I believe it's a grandchild.
Thank you,
Martha,
Lord Jesus.
Right now, I want you to take and put your hands on that child.
Hallelujah.
Because that child does not, he's been diagnosed with leukemia.
Jesus.
But God said right now, Martha, if you touch that child and you believe, that child is healed.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And every one of you, you know that the Lord has done it. You have that prophetic word. I want you to write us, call us,
Let's hear from you because we know that the miracle has taken place. Yes. Just call us right now. Call us and let's hear the testimony. It's done. Receive it. Receive it. Amen. Can we have you sing and we will come back to you? Yeah, I know all the songs that you have, you know, you receive them from the Holy Spirit, Wendy. So go ahead. That's one of the things I didn't say about her, that she flows in the prophetic. And we'll hear more from her. Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
This is
we read it in Matthew, we read it in Mark, we read it in Luke, and we read it in John, that Jesus Christ, our Savior, has come, and someday soon, yes, someday soon, He's taking us home. We open our Bibles to His birth. He was born of a virgin here on earth. He went about doing His Father's will, and this was done, yes, this was done, let it be fulfilled. We read it in Matthew, we read it in Mark, we read it in Luke, and we read it in John, that Jesus Christ, our Savior, has come, and someday soon, yeah, someday soon, He's taking us home. As He went along the way, He met a man, the scriptures say. This man was John, who baptized Him. To the River Jordan, to the River Jordan, my Savior went. We read it in Matthew, we read it in Mark, we read it in Luke, and we read it in John, that Jesus Christ, our Savior, has come, and someday soon, yeah, someday soon, He's taking us home. All right! The Prince of Peace, He was sent to die on Calvary. He took all sin there upon that cross. He bled and died, just He bled and died, and He paid the cost. We read it in Matthew, we read it in Mark, we read it in Luke, and we read it in John, that Jesus Christ, our Savior, has come, and someday soon, yeah, someday soon, He's taking us home. Before Jesus went away, He promised He would return someday to take us to His heavenly home, where we will gather, yes, we will gather around the throne. We read it in Matthew, we read it in Mark, we read it in Luke, and we read it in John, that Jesus Christ, our Savior, has come, and someday soon, yes, someday soon, He's taking us home. And someday soon, yes, someday soon, He's taking us home. And someday soon, yes, someday soon, He's taking us home. Woo!
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Beautiful. Amen. Amen. You started to tell us how this song came about.
Well, I was sitting at home, and I started looking in the Bible, and in the Bible, you know, where it says when Jesus was born, it goes on, and it's in Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, mm-hmm. all those scriptures. Mm-hmm. And if you look at it, if you was to really look at it, you would see that they're all saying the same thing. Mm-hmm. And so I came in and I said, you know what? That would be a perfect song. Mm. Going home.
Beautiful.
I mean, seriously, we are going to be going home.
Home. I love home.
And beautiful. Home is with Jesus.
Yes.
My God.
Mm. Yes. Wow. And how many songs have you written?
I have written probably hundreds of them.
Wow.
I have all kinds of songs. I have the country as well as the country gospel.
Wow.
I you know, the Lord said in His Word to make a joyful noise unto Him. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I have been doing that since I've been proud 11 years old.
Wow. So tell us a little bit about some of the people that you have sang with and some of the things that you're now doing in regards to movies and...
Well, the things that the people that I have written songs for, I have written for several different types of, you know, the country field. I've written for Ricky Van Shelton. I've written for Donna Fargo. I have written for Dolly Parton. Wow. And I have written for myself as well. And I really, you know, my country songs, you know, other people are singing them.
Right? Yeah.
But my gospel that God has given me, I have kept them because I just feel that's what He wanted me to do. Amen. But I see this in the future. Mm-hmm. I see a songbook.
Amen.
And I see this songbook. Amen. And I see all of my songs on there.
Yes.
With the music that everybody else can sing.
Amen.
I see that. Because the Lord had shared with me, Wendy, these aren't just for you. Yes. These are for all of my people.
Amen.
You know, He's just, He plays me. And this is what I tell Him. He plays me. I'm His instrument.
Amen.
And He plays me and uses me for that.
Wow. So about how many Christian country songs do you have?
Christian country songs, I probably have at least 100.
My God.
Wow. So we look forward to that.
Yes.
Now, how can people get hold of you?
They can go through my Facebook. They can go through to Wendy Lynn Adams. I also have a music page on there as Wendy Lynn Adams music page. And I have my fan club, which is Wendy Lynn Fan Club. They can go there and they can purchase my recordings. I'm on SoundCloud. They can go on there and hear some of my songs. And I just got to do recently, the first time I just got to do my Christmas album, and I'm very excited that this year it will be out and people will be able to purchase it. And there's one song on there that is really going to bless a lot of people. And it's called Merry Christmas, Daddy. And it's about children.
Wow.
Their parents, their mommies and daddies are over fighting a war. Mm-hmm. Okay? And wow, these children are left, they don't have their mommy or they don't have their daddy. And it's about this little kid that goes to Santa and he says, I want my daddy home for Christmas.
Wow.
And then it goes on and talks about, I've never remember seeing it, Santa cry. It's a beautiful song. I'm sure you're going to enjoy it.
Amen.
And around Christmas time, I will come back and sing it for
Amen.
Y'all.
Amen. Wow. Praise the Lord.
Praise God.
So when is the album going to be out?
I'm hoping it will be out in November.
November. Okay.
I'm hoping.
So we're waiting for that, and then we will share with the OCN viewers. And introduce the one you brought with today.
Well, I brought somebody very special for me today. She is my personal designer. The clothes that you see me wear, this lady here, O'Shea.
Bless you. Bless you.
She had designs for me.
Wow.
She has her own boutique, and I'm going to let her talk about herself.
Okay. Let's hear from O'Shea. Welcome to OCN.
Thank you.
Amen.
It is a privilege being here, especially with my wonderful team and my body of Christ here
Amen.
Today. I am truly grateful that my name is Shepra, and they call me O'Shea, and that is the name of my boutique. And how it got started is a testimony. It truly is. We'll first go into how it got started was when I was doing hair, and still do it a little bit, but God did a transition in my life, and sometimes we have to be stripped down to bring out the new.
My God.
And so I went through a homeless type of thing, and God had brought me back and told me He's going to transition me and that it would be bigger this time. And that the people He brings in my life are women and men of God.
Amen.
And the gift that he has given me is to bless others. And that is my gift, to give back to others. And how me and Wendy met, praise God. We were on the in LA. And we're going to just go over a little bit. Yeah. And the Lord told me when I saw her on the red carpet to ask her, you have a word for me. And she did. This woman is amazing. She is truly a woman of God. Amen. She showed me and told me her life. And I give God all the praise for her. God is good. And when you trust him, you just leave it in his hands. Sometimes in the boutique, I sit there and I just say, Lord, guide my footsteps, because I don't know where you're going to take me. And he does. He leads you to the right place. If you wait on him, he will lead you in the right place. Don't walk before him. Wait on him. But a little bit about the boutique, I'm so grateful, is that we dress Wendy, and she looks fabulous. And I give God all the praise. And everything I do, I put God first. Amen. He is the one in my life at all times. If you are a designer out there, if you have a dream, trust God and put your vision to him. Don't walk before it. Everything is seasonal, and God's got your back. I am grateful to say that O'Shea Fashion is moving in the right direction. And I'm thankful for the people in my life to be a designer for the lovely Wendy Lynn.
Amen.
She is truly a gift of God.
A magazine.
And, yes, all right. And also, I created the O'Shea magazine. We have some lovely people that are in the magazine. And the magazine is basically a Christ-based magazine. And we basically use Christians and show people who have prominent businesses or is starting a business in my magazine, and even pastors and churches. So we talk, we look at the people who are doing something positive in the community, and that's what it's really about in my magazine. And looking for more to be a part of the magazine. As you know, Wendy is a promoter of my magazine, so I'm truly grateful for that.
She didn't want you to.
I know. And we did get the media award this year for the magazine, and we are going on our fourth issue.
Wow.
And I'm truly grateful for that. I started on faith, and again, I'm so honored to be on this beautiful OCN show. Amen. And all this wonderful blessings and privilege to hear my story from homeless to a blessing.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, it's amazing. I talk about Ananias.
Oh, wow.
That God used to introduce Paul.
Wow. Yes.
We all need an Ananias.
Yes, we
in
do.
Our lives.
Yes, we do.
And I'm telling you, you know, you may say, well, I don't have the millions of dollars, but here the Lord is using her as your Ananias.
That
and
is
I'm
true.
Sure the same thing is happening for them.
Yes.
You know,
true.
She is getting to a place where everyone will hear her song.
Yes.
To be a household song.
Yes, she is.
Starting with the OCN theme song.
That's right.
Truly a privilege.
Amen. Amen. So tell us a little bit more about you. You kind of said a little bit to homeless to blessing.
Yes.
What exactly do you mean by homeless to blessing?
Well, sometimes God takes you through to get you through and to take you through elevations through life. There were certain things that I was not focused on until you have to go through and really understand who God is, what he's doing in our lives.
Okay.
And through my testimony, I had to really seek him and trust him on building his temple. And I say that because with the boutique, I call it my temple, because it's his. And I'm grateful that he helped me build it.
Yeah.
And to be in that situation where you have nothing and you say, Lord, you know, what do I need to do? He says, I've already given it to you.
Amen.
See, the gifts are in us, and God has already given us. We have the chance to use it or abuse it. So you want to use it in the right direction.
Yes.
O'Shea Fashion is helping women, giving them confidence, giving them courage, giving them love through fashion.
Amen.
And help build women in the state of times that they're in. Because right now we're in a really difficult times when it comes to a lot of women are suffering through a lot of things. And so if I can use it in any way through fashion, I am truly grateful. Amen. And so that's what O'Shea is about. It means original, being yourself. Being content,
amen.
Building the word of Christ through fashion.
Knowing that we are complete.
Yes.
Yeah.
And that's what it's all about.
Mm-hmm. Amen. So the fashion is for women.
Yes, it is.
And do you design and then go purchase the outfit, or
yes.
Do you sew, or you have?
Yes. I have a seamstress, okay. And I do design. So I do both. Okay. And so sometimes, like, I have the Angel Wing collection coming out for Wendy Lynn. And the Angel Wing collection is basically I design. And we just had a show, actually, in here in Los Angeles. But you will be seeing the Angel Wing collection by Wendy Lynn, designed by O'Shea.
Oh, which is okay. Good.
Yes.
And look at Wendy Lynn.
So we are truly moving fast and truly grateful to show her designs and do it in a Christian way.
So what she wears, you design and then
yes.
She, does she modify or does she tell you what she wants?
Oh, yeah. I think we're a team. We're a team.
Team.
Yeah. We work together and whatever program she's on, and we both kind of let the Lord lead us and say, okay, today is a nice color for this, or this is a nice color
uh-huh.
for that. So we kind of communicate very well, but we also let the Holy Spirit guide us too.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So for instance, what she's wearing is Wendy Lynn design?
Yeah, this is Wendy.
This is
Wendy loves color, and she also loves to be comfortable. Because of her singing.
I like that. I hear that loud.
She sings. She's classy. She also is just beautiful. So we want to reflect the inside just like the outside. And so it's a package deal. And so she likes color. She likes stretchable fabrics, breathable fabrics, because when you're singing and acting and doing what she does, she has to have something that's elegant but very comfortable. And so that's what she really loves in color. And like I said, she really enjoys those things.
Well, I just like that. That is so beautiful.
Yes.
So all the time that you've been coming here, everything is designed by both of you teaming up together. So now tell me, do you do this over the phone? I know you are in San Diego and she's right here in Los Angeles County. Do you
yes.
do this over the phone? Or?
Yes, we do it over the phone. And she has a collection of my dresses. And I'd be like, okay, we got your new collection coming, or you have a collection already. Let's wear this today. And we both agree on it. And so she's like, yeah, let's do that. So I'm really excited. Wow. And it works out great. Yeah,
yeah, I went
time.
Into her shop the
yes.
other day, and this was there. She said, "This is your dress." Wendy.
Yes.
She
yes.
says, "Go try this on."
Yes.
And I said, "Okay." I said, "This would be perfect."
Yes.
You know. And so then she calls me 2 days ago, and she
yes.
says, "Wendy, wear that on the show."
Yes.
Ah.
Yes.
Ah, so that's how it works.
Yeah, I could feel it. You know.
Okay.
I just said, "Come."
And it's perfect. I mean, when she stepped out of the car, I said, "Wow."
Yeah. Yes.
It's perfect.
She's beautiful.
Are you ready to sing another song?
Sure.
Amen. So let's give it up again for
Amen.
Wendy.
Amen.
Let me share a little bit about this song, please, before I start it. This song is written for my mama.
Amen.
I have been here before and sang about my daddy. Well, this is for my mama. And I hope you enjoy it.
Amen.
If I had the power to call my mother back from a place of splendor to our home across the tracks, I would change one single wrinkle or gray in her hair. For the love of my mother, with Jesus I'll share. I know Jesus has mighty mama by the hand, and is walking with her in that promised land. I know she's free from trouble, sorrow, and pain. Someday I'll see my mother, and she'll be well again. I love my mother dearly. I miss her, heaven knows. To feel her arms around me would be heaven all my own. To hear her voice so tender and see her smiling face. To know she is with Jesus helps me to bear my grief. If I had the power to call my mother back from a place of splendor to our home across the tracks, I wouldn't change one single wrinkle or gray in her hair. For the love of my mother, with Jesus I'll share. I know she is not lonely, for the good book tells me so. She's there with loved ones who's left us long ago. I know if she could come back, she would not want to stay. As she walks along with Jesus, and he guides her all the way. I know when Jesus calls me, I'll see her standing there. She'll be so young and pretty, I'll know her anywhere. She never has to worry about me being there. For I put my life with Jesus, and I know he hears my prayer. I love you, Mama. I miss you. I'll see you someday. Give Daddy a kiss for me.
Pastor David, I want us to go back to that Matthew 6, so we can lead the people that do not know Jesus to the kingdom. You want me to? Let me read it from another translation, and then we can get you started here. So I want to read from the New International. That's Matthew chapter 6, and that's verse 33. It says, "But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well."
That's right.
Amen.
That's
Amen.
Right.
Amen. So no. we want the people to receive Jesus, because that's after that.
Mm-hmm.
That's part of seeking him. And then we will pray for them so they can begin to expect the best in their lives. Amen.
Amen.
You know, one of the best that God has too is in John 10:10.
Yes.
When he says, "I'm come that you might have life."
Hallelujah.
And have it more abundantly.
Amen.
And you see people seeking this all around. We were in Hollywood the other day as we were ministering, and you go out and you see these people that some of them are stumbling around, they're drunk, you see the sadness on their face, and some of them, I watched one guy come by, and he's driving a Rolls Royce convertible, brand new. I mean, didn't even have the license plate on it yet. And he followed us. I kept joking with Wendy that he keeps coming by to see you. And he kept coming by, and they slow down, and he'd come by again. And, you know, this happened. In fact, it's on our way down to O'Shea's.
Wow.
boutique. And I mean, he must have gone for 15 minutes like that, just back and forth, back and forth. And I thought, you know, he's got a brand new Rolls Royce convertible. I don't know what those things cost.
Yes.
But he didn't seem to have happiness.
No. Right.
He didn't seem to have peace.
My God.
And I got my doll, I got God, I got the promises of God, I got the joy of the Lord in my heart. And I've said to Wendy several times, and in fact, when we were ministering, one of the last times I said, you know, I don't know of anything that I would change in our lives. I'm so content.
Amen.
I'm totally content. I love where I live. I love the car we drive. It's not new. All that. It's just exactly what we need, and we love it. And I was saying to Wendy, you know, I'll bet his Rolls Royce isn't half as comfortable as our old car. You're just satisfied with what God has because you've got the joy of the Lord within your heart. A few verses before the verse that we shared there in Matthew 6:33, on verse 9, Jesus teaches his disciples to pray, Our Father, which art in heaven. Our Father, my Father. Wendy sang about Mom. She lived with us for several years. What a beautiful, sweet lady. She was a pastor's wife, loved Jesus, joy of the Lord, always doing everything she could for us. But I think of my dad. You know, when it was his funeral, I said, you know, if there's one word that I could use to express about Dad, was he was a priest. He's a priest to Jesus, first of all. He got up every morning, 4 o'clock in the morning. He never had to set his alarm. That was his time with Jesus. And he'd start the day just ministering
Hallelujah.
To the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Sitting there reading the Bible, and then his eyes would close, and you see his lips moving as he'd be talking to his Heavenly Father.
Hallelujah.
And then he'd pick up a magazine, a Billy Graham one or one of the other ones, and read the things there. But he lived Jesus
Amen.
To the world.
Yes.
You know, when Dad was 86 years old, people would call him to come and do things for them because they were in their 40s and they're too old to do it. So call my dad because he was 86.
Wow.
I mean, the vitality, the health, the things
wow.
like that
Amen.
That God had given him because he lived the promises,
Amen.
And God fulfilled the promises
Amen.
Of abundant living
Amen.
In his life there too. But then it says, hallowed be thy name, praise, honor, and glory to you. But then he talks about, give us this day our daily bread.
Amen.
We talked about that, how he takes care of the sparrows. You know, they don't even worry about tomorrow.
Amen.
They don't worry about what they're going to eat or the other things there. God is taking care of them. And so now for you, those are the promises for you. If you don't have Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior,
Amen.
These promises don't work for you. They work for God's
Amen.
Kids.
Mm-hmm.
My dad took care of his kids. He didn't take care of the kids down the block. My Heavenly Father takes care of his kids.
Mm-hmm.
You're born into his family.
Amen.
In John chapter 3, you're born again. You're born of your mom and dad. You became a human being.
Amen.
You're born of God, and you become born of the Spirit of God.
Amen.
And so you ask him now to come into your life.
Amen.
You ask him to be your Heavenly Father.
Amen.
So that these promises will all work for you too.
Amen.
So if you want to receive Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, and I don't know why anyone would not want to, just mean this and let's talk to God. That's what prayer is, just talking to him.
Amen.
Would you just follow me in a prayer? And mean this in your heart, and you become a child of God
Amen.
When you mean this. Amen. Say, Lord Jesus,
Lord Jesus,
come into my life.
Come into my life.
Be my personal Savior.
Be my personal Savior.
Take away my sins.
Take away my sins.
I'm sorry for them.
I'm sorry for them.
Give me that abundant living.
Give me that abundant living.
Which is you living in my heart.
Which is you living in my heart.
I become the place that you dwell.
I become the place that you dwell.
You'll always be there.
You'll always be there.
You will never leave me.
You will never leave me.
Never forsake me.
Never forsake me.
I am now a child of God.
I am now a child of God.
According to your promises.
According to your promises.
Amen.
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 Welcome
Amen.
To the family of God.
Amen.
You're now my brother and sister in
Amen.
Jesus.
Thank you.
Amen. Amen. And we want to hear from you, writers. Let's hear from you. OCMPO Box 45465.
Los Angeles, California 90045. Praise or go to the website www.ocnbroadcasting.com. Amen. And know this, God loves you and so do we. Amen. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Amen. Amen. The Lord is good.
Yes. Amen.